preoccupation was in preventing a German invasion, and Malta had to make do with what little could be scraped together. The battle for Malta would determine the course of the war in the Mediterranean. The struggle was determined by the British ability to build up and preserve Malta as an offensive base in waters where the nearness of Sicily and the Italian mainland meant that it should have been dominated by Axis air and sea power. The British faced the ongoing struggle of running fast ships and convoys to maintain their island fortress, while the Axis decided how best to eliminate, or at least neutralize it. This struggle determined the success of the campaign in North Africa and the fate of the campaign in the Mediterranean. The founder of Italian fascism was Benito Mussolini, or Il Duce, meaning the leader. Mussolini was Prime Minister of Italy from 1922 until his overthrow in 1943. His ambitions are central to understanding the course of the Mediterranean campaign. Mussolini was a superb organizer and spellbinding orator who founded the modern Italian state. A First World War veteran who had been wounded in action with the elite Bersaglieri on the Italian front, Mussolini established a black-shirted militia whose badge and name was taken from the bundle of reeds or fasces used as a symbol of office by the officials of ancient Rome. He was an effective administrator who won his country's approval in a series of social improvements and large-scale public works, and is still known as the man who made the trains run on time. Hitler admired what Mussolini had achieved in Italy and copied the fascist Roman salute and black shirts for his own Nazi party. Mussolini dreamt of re-establishing Rome's empire in the Mediterranean, the Mare Nostrum. Embarking on a series of military adventures to achieve this goal, he dragged an unwilling country into World War II, but lacked the resources and industrial base to achieve his ambitions. Il Duce's forces suffered military humiliation on land and at sea. His campaigns in North Africa and in Albania and Greece had to be rescued from complete disaster by Germany's intervention. As the war progressed, however, Mussolini lost Hitler's respect and became more and more of a liability within the Axis alliance. Mussolini was deposed when the Allies invaded Sicily in 1943. Rescued from imprisonment by a daring raid by German special forces, he headed a puppet government in northern Italy until the last days of the war. Under the fascist government of General Franco, Spain also had ambitions in the Mediterranean. Franco wanted to expand the Spanish Empire with the addition of Gibraltar, French Morocco, and parts of French West Africa, as well as guaranteed food and arms supplies from Germany. Franco was encouraged by Hitler to join in a joint attack on Gibraltar to close Britain's western gateway into the Mediterranean. But Spain was exhausted from the Spanish Civil War and was reluctant to commit to another war. Hitler found Franco to be a deft negotiator, and after a protracted meeting between the two in October 1940, he remarked that he would rather have three or four teeth extracted than have another similar meeting. Franco voiced support, but promised nothing. But conscious of his country's dependence on imported foodstuffs, Franco was prepared to assist in Hitler's ambitions in Russia, but refused to move against Gibraltar. The Mediterranean theatre of war was central to the British Prime Minister Winston Churchill's strategic concept for waging the Second World War. After the fall of France, Churchill's only means of striking at Germany was with the bombing campaign by the RAF, and this remained a cornerstone of his strategy throughout the war. As First Lord of the Admiralty in both wars, and a fervent believer in the importance of naval power, Churchill believed that Britain should deliberately fight a campaign on the periphery, like the Mediterranean, as part of the wearing down process of the Axis powers, before confronting them in northwest Europe. Britain's hold on the Mediterranean was dependent on its naval bases at Gibraltar, Malta, and on Cyprus, which gave it strategically important positions in the west, central, and eastern Mediterranean, supported by the Royal Navy's main base at Alexandria in Egypt. After the fall of France, Churchill's military advisers regarded the Mediterranean as unimportant and recommended retreating to Gibraltar. Churchill did not. Churchill wanted to fight a campaign in the Mediterranean. It fitted in with his strategic view of winning the war. It offered the prospect of invading Sicily or Sardinia and placing Italy under pressure. Always looking for options, Churchill saw success in the Mediterranean as a means of persuading Vichy France to change sides and of convincing Franco's Spain to remain neutral. Churchill's strategy was to wage a three-stage war in which the bombing and naval blockade of 1940 would be followed by medium-sized amphibious operations in the Mediterranean in 1941 against targets such as Sardinia and Sicily, building up to larger scale attacks on the European coast in 1942. German success in North Africa and the Balkans, followed by Japan's entry into the war, would modify this. But in 1940, the Mediterranean was the only theatre where Britain had the resources to make the first stage of his strategy possible. Much would depend on the resourcefulness of Admiral A.B. Cunningham, the commander-in-chief of the Mediterranean fleet. Cunningham faced a now superior Italian fleet consisting of seven battleships, including the two impressive new battleships Vittorio Veneto and Littorio, seven heavy and 11 light cruisers, 61 destroyers, and over 100 submarines. Against this, Cunningham had four battleships, three of which were not modernized and were both slower and outgunned by their Italian opposites, six light cruisers and 20 destroyers. The Vichy government of defeated France was still a viable Mediterranean power, with forces positioned in Algeria, the Mediterranean coast of which formed part of metropolitan France, French Morocco and Tunisia, as well as the mandated territories of Syria and Lebanon. The French army in Africa was also well armed with modern weapons and fiercely loyal to the Vichy regime. By 1939, the French navy under Admiral Darlan was the fourth largest in the world. It was very modern and professionally manned. After the fall of France, an ad hoc force called Force H under Admiral Somerville was put together at Gibraltar to fill the gap left by the French in the Western Mediterranean. A powerful force of four capital ships, it went some way to redress the balance. It consisted of Somerville's flagship, the battlecruiser Hood, the battleships Valiant and Resolution, the aircraft carrier Ark Royal, the light cruiser Arethusa, and four destroyers. Its principal task was to ensure that the French fleet did not fall into German hands. On the 3rd of July 1940, Force H attacked the French naval base at Merselkebir near Oran in Algeria. It was a gamble that risked bringing Vichy France back into the war on the side of the Axis. After prolonged negotiations, the French still refused to immobilize their powerful fleet of two battleships, two modern battlecruisers, 13 destroyers, and four submarines. Somerville opened fire and followed this up with torpedo attacks from Swordfish from the Ark Royal. The battleship Britannia blew up with heavy loss of life. Torpedoes in a second attack crippled a second battleship, the French flagship Dunkirk, 3 days later. On the 5th of July, the battleship Richelieu was attacked and damaged in the port of Dakar by torpedo bombers from the aircraft carrier Hermes. These naval attacks created enormous tension between Britain and France's Vichy government. It confirmed in the Vichy mind the image of perfidious Albion, who had abandoned France at Dunkirk and who now were prepared to strike and kill Frenchmen in pursuit of a war it believed Britain could not win. It was Churchill's signal to the world that despite all odds, Britain, although alone in Europe, would stop at nothing to win the war in the Mediterranean. General Sir Archibald Wavell was Commander-in-Chief Middle East from the outbreak of war until July 1941, when General Sir Claude Auchinleck replaced him. General Harold Alexander, who together with Lieutenant General Bernard Montgomery formed a formidable partnership that engineered Rommel's defeat in North Africa, in turn would replace Auchinleck. With his air force and naval equivalents, Wavell formed a high command. Preoccupation was in preventing a German invasion, and Malta had to make do with what little could be scraped together. The battle for Malta would determine the course of the war in the Mediterranean. The struggle was determined by the British ability to build up and preserve Malta as an offensive base in waters where the nearness of Sicily and the Italian mainland meant that it should have been dominated by Axis air and sea power. The British faced the ongoing struggle of running fast ships and convoys to maintain their island fortress, while the Axis decided how best to eliminate, or at least neutralize it. This struggle determined the success of the campaign in North Africa and the fate of the campaign in the Mediterranean. The founder of Italian fascism was Benito Mussolini, or Il Duce, meaning the leader. Mussolini was Prime Minister of Italy from 1922 until his overthrow in 1943. His ambitions are central to understanding the course of the Mediterranean campaign. Mussolini was a superb organizer and spellbinding orator who founded the modern Italian state. A First World War veteran who'd been wounded in action with the elite Bersaglieri on the Italian front, Mussolini established a black-shirted militia whose badge and name was taken from the bundle of reeds or fasces used as a symbol of office by the officials of ancient Rome. He was an effective administrator who won his country's ear. Churchill did not. Churchill wanted to fight a campaign in the Mediterranean. It fitted in with his strategic view of winning the war. It offered the prospect of invading Sicily or Sardinia and placing Italy under pressure. Always looking for options, Churchill saw success in the Mediterranean as a means of persuading Vichy France to change sides and of convincing Franco's Spain to remain neutral. Churchill's strategy was to wage a three-stage war in which the bombing and naval blockade of 1940 would be followed by medium-sized amphibious operations in the Mediterranean in 1941 against targets such as Sardinia and Sicily, building up to larger-scale attacks on the European coast in 1942. German success in North Africa and the Balkans, followed by Japan's entry into the war, would modify this. But in 1940, the Mediterranean was the only theater where Britain had the resources to make the first stage of his strategy possible. Much would depend on the resourcefulness of Admiral A.B. Cunningham, the commander-in-chief of the Mediterranean fleet. Cunningham faced a now superior Italian fleet consisting of seven battleships, including the two impressive new battleships Vittorio Veneto and Littorio, seven heavy and 11 light cruisers, 61 destroyers, and over 100 submarines. Against this, Cunningham had four battleships, three of which were not modernized and were both slower and outgunned by their Italian opposites, six light cruisers and 20 destroyers. The Vichy government of defeated France was still a viable Mediterranean power, with forces positioned in Algeria, the Mediterranean coast of which formed part of metropolitan France, French Morocco, and Tunisia, as well as the mandated territories of Syria and Lebanon. The French army in Africa was also well armed with modern weapons and fiercely loyal to the Vichy regime. By 1939, the French navy, under Admiral Darlan, was the fourth largest in the world. It was very modern and professionally manned. After the fall of France, an ad hoc force called Force H under Admiral Somerville was put together at Gibraltar to fill the gap left by the French in the Western Mediterranean. A powerful force of four capital ships, it went some way to redress the balance. It consisted of Somerville's flagship, the battle cruiser Hood, the battleships Valiant and Resolution, the aircraft carrier Ark Royal, the light cruiser Arethusa, and four destroyers. Its principal task was to ensure that the French fleet did not fall into German hands. On the 3rd of July 1940, Force H attacked the French naval base at Mers-el-Kébir near Oran in Algeria. It was a gamble that risked bringing Vichy France back into the war on the side of the Axis. After prolonged negotiations, the French still refused to immobilize their powerful fleet of 2 battleships, 2 modern battlecruisers, 13 destroyer approval in a series of social improvements and large-scale public works, and is still known as the man who made the trains run on time. Hitler admired what Mussolini had achieved in Italy and copied the fascist Roman salute and black shirts for his own Nazi party. Mussolini dreamt of re-establishing Rome's empire in the Mediterranean, the Mare Nostrum. Embarking on a series of military adventures to achieve this goal, he dragged an unwilling country into World War II, but lacked the resources and industrial base to achieve his ambitions. Il Duce's forces suffered military humiliation on land and at sea. His campaigns in North Africa and in Albania and Greece had to be rescued from complete disaster by Germany's intervention. As the war progressed, however, Mussolini lost Hitler's respect and became more and more of a liability within the Axis alliance. Mussolini was deposed when the Allies invaded Sicily in 1943. Rescued from imprisonment by a daring raid by German special forces, he headed a puppet government in northern Italy until the last days of the war. Under the fascist government of General Franco, Spain also had ambitions in the Mediterranean. Franco wanted to expand the Spanish Empire with the addition of Gibraltar, French Morocco, and parts of French West Africa, as well as guaranteed food and arms supplies from Germany. Franco was encouraged by Hitler to join in a joint attack on Gibraltar to close Britain's western gateway into the Mediterranean. But Spain was exhausted from the Spanish Civil War and was reluctant to commit to another war. Hitler found Franco to be a deft negotiator, and after a protracted meeting between the two in October 1940, he remarked that he would rather have 3 or 4 teeth extracted than have another similar meeting. Franco voiced support, but promised nothing. But conscious of his country's dependence on imported foodstuffs, Franco was prepared to assist in Hitler's ambitions in Russia, but refused to move against Gibraltar. The Mediterranean theatre of war was central to the British Prime Minister Winston Churchill's strategic concept for waging the Second World War. After the fall of France, Churchill's only means of striking at Germany was with the bombing campaign by the RAF, and this remained a cornerstone of his strategy throughout the war. As First Lord of the Admiralty in both wars, and a fervent believer in the importance of naval power, Churchill believed that Britain should deliberately fight a campaign on the periphery, like the Mediterranean, as part of the wearing down process of the Axis powers, before confronting them in northwest Europe. Britain's hold on the Mediterranean was dependent on its naval bases at Gibraltar, Malta, and on Cyprus, which gave it strategically important positions in the west, central, and eastern Mediterranean, supported by the Royal Navy's main base at Alexandria in Egypt. After the fall of France, Churchill's military advisers regarded the Mediterranean as unimportant and recommended retreating to Gibraltar.